You know, I've lived here most of my life in Uptown, and I walk by this theater every day, and it's just collecting dust. It doesn't make sense. You know, we've got a lot of venues, I understand, but this is a landmark. It's a part of Chicago. It's history. It's another example of the arts just failing in the system. Nobody cares to keep a good thing going, and
to fully comprehend and understand its glory and beauty of the Uptown, we really have to trace its origins, go back to its history. It was one of the original Balaban and Katz movie houses. It was built by the Rap and Rap architectural firm, and they spared no expense. The theater itself became the largest and grandest picture house known in the world. After the Granada was torn down, it really was a standalone compared to anything you've ever seen. IMAX doesn't even compare to what the Uptown was. At the height of the movie theater era, in the 50s, the Uptown was very successful. It had a huge revenue stream. It wasn't a problem. Single theater picture houses were very common. This was the case up until the 70s, where you'd get more multiplexes springing up, and a single screen just couldn't keep up with what the multiplexes had to offer. And this led to the Rebellia family, who took over the theater. They would have concerts after they could take the screen down and adjust it for more of a concert setting. It was very common, actually, to have boxing matches on closed circuit. This was a small way to keep things afloat. Around the early 80s, the Rebellia family could no longer afford to keep it operational, so they did get bankrupt, and it ended up turning over into the hands of the city. Now, during that time, in the mid-80s, around 84, it was suggested to several council members that it should be placed on one of the landmarks of Chicago. And it was at this point, while they were in much litigation and debate over what to do with the Uptown, that Plitt Theaters jumped in and made a bid on the Uptown. What one of the conditions were to have the Uptown in their name is they would have to run the heating and maintain the facility while they were still in litigation over whether to place it officially on the landmark list. When all was said and done, after Plitt Theaters took over, they didn't hold up their end of the bargain. They just flat out lied. They never ran the heating, which resulted in cold winters coming in and freezing the pipes over. And as anyone knows, when water freezes, it expands. When that happens in pipes, the pipes burst. Now, this was already old piping to begin with, so you can imagine when it just keeps pouring over itself over the course of a winter, the water just builds and builds and builds and freezes on top of itself. The number one enemy against the Uptown Theater is time. With every passing winter, it just takes a bigger and bigger beating. Over time, the moisture just builds up and it just erodes what's remaining of its original integrity. The second biggest threat to the Uptown is Uptown itself. It's in the largest theater district in Chicago. You've got the Aragon Ballroom on one side, the Riviera to the other. You've got the Green Mill right beside it. If they do decide to open it up, one of the conditions met is they'll have to, without a doubt, open up a new public parking facility right by it. And that seems like a good idea, but the only problem is the current parking is controlled by private citizens. Now, they stand to lose a lot of money if it's built, and they don't want that money out of their pockets. There's really no way of knowing exactly what's going to happen. It's either going to collapse in on itself, and there's going to be no one to know. No one's going to cry for it. But that's part of the problem. We need the awareness. We need to spread the word of this gem hitting and hiding in everyone's backyard. Everyone knows about Wrigley Field. Everyone knows that's a treasure. Oh, we can't replace Wrigley Field. Well, you can't replace the Uptown. You just can't do it. There's one thing that comes into play when discussing its future, and that's the logistics of it. Is the money worth it? And when we speak about this at Friends of the Uptown, well, there's just There's just no question when you hear people speaking about the logistics of it, they haven't seen the uptown.